Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. This is the third video on how to initiate SSH connection from Jump Host using Python. In the previous video, we have seen how to write a basic script for initiating SSH from a Jump device. You can see it is trying to connect to the Jump Host 0.18. It is connected to 18, it is a Linux machine, and from there it is initiating SSH to Cisco 0.50 and executing commands. Now we'll see how to handle some of the basic exceptions. I'll just give one invalid IP here for Jump Host. So you can see here I'm getting netmiko exception. Let me copy that exception. Similar to that, let us check for the authentication failed message. Yeah. Now we got two exception messages from netmiko. We'll try handling those two. For that, first we need to import that SSH exceptions, then here we'll give try . Let us put everything under try. Here we'll give except, we'll put the exception what we received. And in this case, we'll just print jump host not reachable, and another exception. Jump host authentication failed. Now let us try executing it. You can see I'm getting now authentication failed message. Similar to that, here we already have one if statement. If we don't get password prompt, what will happen? It won't try initiating connection to the machine, the end machine. So what we can do, if we don't get password prompt, we'll give else statement here. We'll just print unable to connect to the destination device. Now here in the destination device, I'll give different IP. Okay, here I'm using wrong username. Now it is connected to the gem host, and you can see here I'm getting the message unable to connect to the destination device. You can even get all the messages and handle it in more granular way. This is just to simplify the script. I just handled only very basic exceptions. Now here in this script, if you see, I have made the messaging bit more proper. You can see here, let me just run this script once. I added proper spacing and all, but if you compare both scripts, the script logic is same. It is more readable. Here it is connecting to the gem host and it is printing the prompt. Then it says the message connected to the gem host. Then destination router, it is executing this command for initiating SSH. Then after receiving password prompt, it prints received. Then destination device prompt, it is printing here. Then each command, it is giving the prompt name, and then it is saying it is executing the command. If you compare these two scripts, logic is going to be same in both scripts. Here only what I did is this messaging, I made it bit more readable. In the next video, we'll see how to use a Cisco device as gem host for initiating connection. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.